Hello and welcome, I'm Arumba. Thank you for joining me. Let's play some more Romuvan Raiders. Crusader Kings 2. Keep on upgrading this place here. Wooden Hill Fort has been complete in Sambia. Okay, that needs to continue to get upgraded. Ooh, a shipbuilder. Nice. Not particularly interested in upgrading these ones down here. Then again, I might hold on to them. I mean, this is all in this duchy, primarily this duchy of Great Moravia. Is it not? Yeah, that's three counties. This one would be wonderful. In hindsight, if I could take that back, probably would. But it would require killing everyone now, so I guess we just leave it be. Pleased to report that the majority have converted. So our religion is strong, spreading. Looks like we've mostly gotten rid of the old Romuva. Most people are embracing our brand, our version of Romuva. So we are making positive income despite the retinue. The retinue is, I don't think, fully reinforced. Almost. Okay. I want to embrace feudalism. So long as we don't lose raiding, I don't see any disadvantage to it. Being a raiding feudal due to our religion, that's awesome. Alright, so we have our war goal. And now we'll go raid. I think we should go raid her. I said raid. This is a funny game. She could still have an army, so we'll keep the armies kind of strong. See, she's actually willing to engage in a 1,000 stack. Because it's just light infantry. So if we went down to 500, we would get kind of, you know, messed up a bit. I'd say it's justifiable to raise the levy. So many that are pathing the wrong way. Kelmno. Marienburg? Marienburg, war camp, yeah. More guys. I will honor every call, because I'm a good Romuva. Yes, yes, I am. Okay. So now we can finally kind of get these armies to move together. Supply is great. Lost our spymaster. Ten 10,000 troops. A lot of men. I'd say. It's more than this guy's got. This guy's only got 7. We should go raid him a bit. I mean, the army's already here. No. I mean, I don't really care about her. I do care about weakening this guy. Plus, these forts are more exposed. There's more gold available right now. So let's head to here. We border these 3 with that province. So once we get here, we'll split the armies about 4 ways. We'll just make it 3, I guess. Split. Select split. Grab the largest one. Split. Split. And it's close. Close to 3 ways. And let's see how we do. All I need now is a siege leader, organizer, raider. Can you imagine a siege leader, organizer? The hordes are coming. And by hordes, of course, I mean, the pagans. Alright, so from here, I don't really see us being able to siege down 3 then, because they're so willing to engage me with all this light infantry, that what we're going to do is we're going to do a quick little shuffle balance between these two armies, so that they're about the same size, and they're both fairly strong and safe. I would hope. No, that army's gonna probably come for us, I think. Just stay here. 7,000 over there is fine. He's not gonna engage 7. And what's this all about? Why are you independent? England? England, what are you doing over here? You're confused. Look at that. She's actually put together an army. She's trying to fight back. Well, if we can finish one or both of these sieges. Yep, so he's going for the weaker army. Rats. Crap. We can get there not very fast. We have defensive advantages. I don't really want to fight you, though. That's the thing. Apparently I'm here, and I'm here. I'm both places at once, because I'm awesome. I'm a badass. Totally capable. Oh, man, look at that. We won. Aha. We gained 2 whole military technology points and some prestige. You guys suck. Who knows? Maybe that'll cause him to lose a war. My son became a brilliant strategist, inspiring a leader. And you shall marry this 19-year-old. Oi, excuse me. I feel like I'm getting sick. A sneeze does not necessarily mean you're sick, but I feel like it could be. Okay, we're fine on morale. Left flank's dead. It only had a few troops to begin with. Right flank, same way. So he's going to give us a nice, nice 270% flanking bonus in the center. Assuming it even lasts that long, which is not. That's a lot of war score right there. Nice conversion. You can surrender now if you want. I'm just saying it's an option. We don't have to keep this up. Okay. Let's go ahead and stand down the levee. Give it a couple years to replenish. It got beat up quite a bit. We didn't even get to actually do any real raiding against this guy. But, you know, we're starting to poke around a bit. We're getting to that point where we feel strong. I'll do it. Great thing about having brilliant strategists is that I don't mind teaching anyone. I want everyone to become military focused. Military is definitely the best. Centralization could go up. Nah. We tried turning it off and back on again. Let's see. Still Great Moravia over there. So we're just still trying to focus on fixing those borders. Messing. Independent? He's currently revolting against his liege. Great. All the things. Get him. Quickly, get there before anyone else can. We want priority on the siege. Are we hostile? I think we are hostile. To you? Nope, you are not. Excellent. We're neutral. Good, good. Currently revolting against his liege in the Queen Yaroslava of Great Moravia's war to revoke Meissen. So, by all means, feel free to rebel. We will take great opportunity. Once we get 10 to 1, I'm going to assault. Ugh, it's still rather painful, isn't it? It's not. God, it's more than 10 to 1. It should be fine. 20 to 1 is the magic number, I think, in CK2, but... Then again, you know, light infantry, they're so bad at attacking in the skirmish phase, which is what's used for assaults, so it's just very expensive. I wonder why it doesn't say the fort level on this screen. You can see it if you look here, kind of. You actually have to be, looking there, 1.2, 2.0. It just seems relevant to the siege. So you'd assume that it would be there, but it's not. So we're maimed. Don't worry, it's just our left ring finger. You surrender, we accept. See, war is where he's revolting. I'm not going to try to push for that last siege. You know, it just seems too risky. This was a great opportunity to avoid that truce timer. Are you still my tribute? You're not. Declare war. All the things, kill it. Except for those. See, the thing is, tributes don't last very long. They're nice, but... See how quickly, like, I could have sworn we had just done this war. So if we die, we get to play as our brother. And if he dies, it goes to me. Crap. Pagan attrition. I don't think I've had a siege leader in forever. I really want one. barracks has been built. Wait, what? Oh. Alright, I didn't do that. Son of the Host War. My nephew has declared war on me. Amassed a fairly sizable army. We want to master probably flat terrain or light foot. We'll do light foot. It's 20 versus 20. But it's all the time versus only on the right terrain. I think we're the same attributes as my father. What he had had. Okay, where's the host? Up here? Mostly light infantry. If you could go ahead and surrender. That would be great, because then I could put these other 1,800 troops over here to help out. As is, this fight would be pretty close, and I don't like close fights. One last fight, and then we're going to have to take a break, I think. We continue just to spend our prestige with reckless abandon, because why not? This levy is getting to be quite crazy. It was better when we had 26 Marshall, but... Alright, that's good enough, I think. Alright, we're gonna balance ourselves in the center because we're awesome. Put you there, put you there. So we don't get the largest army. But we have, can we put the retinue in the center? Yeah, the retinue is lots of light infantry, and I'm good at reading. I'm good at leading retinue. Light infantry. See, that's not balanced at all now. There we go. I like it. Dominate that center. Yeah, we crushed him before we even got to the melee phase. Now we just get to flank like a boss. Done. We win. But then we get nothing. We get absolutely nothing from this. Which means that they're just literally annoying. And nothing else. Still, the Wendish Empire is looking quite nice. That is not part of the Wendish Empire. That is, so we need to take that. And then we need to take these two. Which means we gotta go roll with Great Moravia again. Which means we want her to die. And then other than that, I still don't know why that one's dark, but it is part of our empire already. And then we're done. We're done expanding, and we can just focus on trying to feudalize and raid. So, since we can't attack her, let's just go raid all of her territory. For fun. Until she hates us. Forever. I never did get you working on somebody again, did I? Okay. Well, she's obviously not going to like this, but it doesn't matter. Hey, women! We like women. Women are delicious. We should cook them. With a small amount of, oh, I don't know, spices and seasoning. Want a piece of this? I don't think so. Alright, cool. I'm gonna take a break here. I look forward to seeing you again in the next video. As always, thanks for watching. See you soon.